Hello, Hema friends! Today we are going to give you a new two-handed sword made by Malos Martialis. If you don't know Malos Martialis, just check under this video in the video description and you will find both the link to his Facebook page and to his website. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so let's start from the weapon stats. As I've said before, this weapon is shaped on a Type 15A following the Oxshot typology. Now, this shape is extremely good if you want to practice both Fiore di Libero Italian longsword or the early German tradition. This is simply because at that time this shape was extremely common due to the fact that it is extremely versatile and can be used both in armored or unarmored situations. You can choose an overall length of the sword between 150 cm and 120 cm. Taking in consideration that in general we are a bit taller than the average medieval people, this kind of length is extremely good, simply because we can find a very huge number of actual findings of actual medieval swords of this shape between 105 and 115 centimeters. So, an overall length of 115 and 120, in my opinion, is extremely good. You can choose a blade length between 85 and 92 centimeters, which is extremely good. But remember, the blade length is of course related to the length of the handle. Now, on this kind of sword, a medieval longsword, I would suggest you to not buy a handle which is too long, but try to stay between 27 and 23 centimeters, pommel included. The blade width at the base is 4.5 centimeters. The crossguard is 25 centimeters, which is extremely good. I have tested a number of longsword during my career, and I like a lot longsword with quite large crossguards, simply because it is more easy to collect the opponent's swords, but also because a large crossguard saves your hands and sometimes also your forearms during the actions. The weight is between 1.4 and 1.55 kilos. It is extremely good, quite light, and it makes this sword flight really easily. You can also customize your own sword with a number of available options. There are a number of pommel shapes, of crossguard shapes. You can choose the letter of your grip, and there is even the option for a crossguard shape. The starting price for this kind of sword is 427 euro. Now, some of you may think that this price is quite high, but if you take in consideration this kind of sword, yes, it is a standard product, but it is a high level standard product, simply because it moves more or less like a sharp sword, it have really good stats, it is extremely good looking, you have a very good number of options to customize it, and in general it is a very good long sword, a very good replica. So in my opinion, this price is fair. Okay, so I have tested this sword in a number of different situations, of different environments. Solo drills, para drills, sparrings, different kind of sparrings. And what I have noticed is that this sword is something in the middle between a blunt sword and a sharp sword. And this is because this replica shares a lot of things in common with a sharp sword. The tip is quite thin, the edge is quite thin too. The overall shape is similar to the one of an actual sharp sword. And because of all these motivations, the weight distribution is extremely similar to the one of a sharp sword. So, these aspects can bring a lot of benefits to your training, but you have to consider it also in the negative perspective. Or better, you have to pay attention when you use this kind of sword, because it is made in a certain way. So let's start analyzing the different aspects of training that I have said before, and let's start to think the different way in which this weapon can be used. So during the soldiers, this sword is extremely good, and this is because the sharp like thing that I have said before. When you use a blunt sword and a sharp sword that weigh the same, you will probably notice that the sharp sword feels far more lighter than the blunt one. And in this case, this replica, it is more similar to a sharp sword. So it feels lighter and it moves in a very easy way. So you can drill more with this simply because it feels lighter, and it is lighter. That said, this sword is really good in soldiers. For the paired drills, this sword is extremely good too, but you have to take in consideration the shape of the blade, so the tip is quite thin, and when you do action which are thrust related, try to take this in consideration. Pay attention. The blade of this sword is quite flexible, so this compensates a bit this aspect of the tip, pay attention when you land your thrust, simply. For the cutting action, nothing to say, the blade moves in a perfect way, the sword is, as I've said before, extremely realistic, and you will find it extremely satisfying. For the sparring, I will spend a bit more words. Now, when you use this sword in sparring, you first of all, you should analyze which kind of sparring you want to do. If you want to do light sparring, a controlled sparring, this sword is perfect. You don't have to think about anything, simply because in general, when you do light sparring, you control any kind of action that you do. And so this sword is perfect for light sparring. When you put the jacket on, it's different. You have to analyze which kind of thing you want to train to use the sword in sparring with protections. If you want to do a sparring which is more technical, you just for a moment set aside your maximum speed, maximum force, to try things and try to use a sharp-like weapon in a more free context, you can use it. But you should not use it in a, as I said before, full force, full speed environment, simply because you risk to damage both the opponent, but also your own sword, because as we have seen, this sword is quite similar to a sharp sword, and so the life is similar to the one of a sharp sword, something in the middle between a replica, an actual blunt sword, and a sharp sword. If you bash too hard with this sword, a lot of times you risk to damage it, and this is what you should not do, because this sword is made for practicing in a specific way. And so if you want to bash at full speed, full force, which is legit, and I do it too, just buy a Federsbert or a blunt replica with an edge which is quite thick. This one is, as I've said before, more sharp-like, and you should use it for what it is. Okay, guys, so I hope this video will help you. I hope that you will like this review. And as you have probably noticed, this is the first time that I use my new microphone, and I want to thank my patrons, because thanks to them I have this new microphone and the software to use it, of course. You guys are the best. Thanks for your support every time, and I hope this video will help you guys. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.